हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ सतीश कटारिया। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दी लेक्चर नंबर 3 ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर सब्जेक्ट एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ लेक्चर इज एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। सो हियर आई हैव लिस्ट आउट सेवरल एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। अपार्ट फ्रॉम देयर दिस देयर आर several other applications are also there, but we have listed out most common applications of the microcontrollers nowadays where the microcontroller uses. Okay, so we will discuss one by one applications and how the microcontroller will use in this particular applications. We will understand this, so you guys understand very well that what is the importance of microcontroller nowadays. Okay, before we start with this one by one application and where the microcontroller use in this particular applications, we will briefly first understand that how many types of microcontrollers are there, or how we can classify the different microcontrollers, or which are the parameters based on that we can classify the microcontrollers. Okay, so first and common parameter, which is based on bus width, we can classify the microcontroller is of 8-bit microcontroller, 16-bit or 32-bit. When the microcontroller having a higher number of bits or bus width, then it can process faster. Okay, so the 32-bit microcontroller is more powerful compared to 8-bit microcontroller. We have to study 8051 microcontroller in our syllabus, which is nothing but the 8-bit microcontroller. Okay, we can classify the microcontrollers based on memory. That means the memory is embedded memory or the external memory. That means the memory, meaning of embedded memory is in chip. Okay, and external memory means microcontroller does not having on chip memory. We need to connect additional memories, like previous versions of 80 family was 8031 microcontroller. There were no memory inside the chip. So this such type of microcontrollers are called the external memory type of microcontroller. We can also categorize the microcontroller based on the instruction set it supports. Okay, so there are two types of instruction sets available for microcontroller universally, that is CISC and RISC. The full form of CISC is complex instruction set computer, and RISC is reduced instruction set computer. One of the instruction set will be used by the microcontroller, okay, both having pros and cons. Okay, so we have to discuss this particular things in detail during the another sessions. Okay, we can also categorize a microcontroller or classify based on its architecture, means how they are made up or which architecture is used to develop the microcontroller chip. Okay, so there are mainly two types of architectures available: Harvard architecture and von Neumann architecture. Okay, so this also we have to study it in a one different video lecture. Okay, so these are the several parameters. Based on this, we can classify the microcontroller. Other than that, there are other parameters also there, that how much memories are available on chip, which are the peripherals available, how many pins are available, what is the execution speed of the microcontroller. So according to that, we can also classify the microcontrollers. But these are the main important points. Based on that, we can classify the microcontrollers. Now, we can see that from this diagram, there are various chip available which is developed by different companies. Okay, so it is a 8089C51, which is developed by Atmel and which is having a core of 8051. Okay, so this is a microchip company, PIC. Okay, this is again Atmel 8 mega series, and this is again 8 mega series, mega 328p. Okay, so now we have to understand that there are families available in a microcontrollers like 8051. So 8051 is nothing but the name of the core, but this core will be used by different companies and they will develop 8051 based their own chip, like Atmel company, Microchip, or Douglas, or Philips. So these all companies are uses the core of 8051 microcontroller and develop their own chip. Okay, similar way the different families are available of microcontroller, like 8051, PEEK, AVR. Okay, so these are the name of the family, and in the family there are various microcontrollers with different facilities. Okay, you can also see the microcontrollers of particular different bits. Okay, 8-bit microcontroller, okay, 16-bit microcontroller, 32-bit microcontroller, and 64-bit is also available nowadays. Okay, so if you go higher the bits of processing or the bus width of the microcontroller, then it will execute, or its speed of execution will be faster. Now you can see various development boards are available in the market. Most popular board is Arduino board that you all are right now uses for your different types of projects. This is again another development board for PEEK microcontroller. This is for 8051 microcontroller. So right now, to start up with the microcontroller, or to learn start learning the microcontroller, you need some development boards. Okay, and in this board you can write a code, execute a code, and you can achieve whatever you want to do with such type of boards. There are variety of boards available nowadays in a market. So you can purchase any of the board and you can start learning the microcontrollers. Now let us discuss the applications of microcontrollers, okay, one by one. So I have given the brief introduction that how you can classify the microcontrollers based on which parameters. Then you can see there are families available for microcontrollers. So you have to select that on which family we have to do the work, or which microcontroller I required. Okay, so that is the primary things that you have to know. That if I want to give the simple example, that if you want to buy a mobile, then you will see particular brand, company name, or its specifications, camera size, RAM size, processor. So similar way, as per our requirement of the application, we have to select a particular microcontroller which is most suitable for particular application. Okay, now we will discuss one by one applications of the microcontroller. So first I have written which is the industrial automation. Nowadays in the industry there are lots of automation and automatic work is going on to reduce the labor work. Okay, now I have shown you two pictures on the slide, which is a Coca-Cola plant and Maruti Suzuki plant. Okay, so you can see that there is no human intervention in the packaging of the Coca-Cola bottles and to manufacture a car. Okay, so there are various instruments are controlling whole flow of the process of automation. So this is nothing but the several mechanical parts are there, several electronics parts are there, and several electrical parts are there. So combination of all these fields will gives the output as a automatic plant. Okay, and it will gives a high volume of production and a good quality of production. So in this when we are consider focusing on the electronic part, then that is a main microcontroller based circuits are available which will controlling a electrical part, and further this electrical part will control the mechanical part, and whole system works in the synchronization. Okay, so second, you can see the plant of Maruti car manufacturing. So there are automatic robots, you can see here. Okay, so these robots are automatic assembling the car. Okay, so this car, what part or which assembly they have to do at which place, so that all these things will be programmed, and according to that program they will work, and this is whole things is controlled by the one circuit, and that circuit is containing the microcontrollers. Okay, now we will see the second application, consumer electronics. Okay, so in a consumer electronics, we are going to use variety of products in a day by day life, in our home and routine life, like refrigerator, washing machine, you can say oven. Okay, so laptops, sound systems, mixer grinder, okay, iPod. So there are variety of things that we are going to use in a day-to-day life, which is nothing but our gadgets. This all having a microcontroller systems inside it. Okay, let us take one example, that refrigerator. Okay, so refrigerator contains cooling elements, then compressor or mechanical parts and electrical motors and one circuit. So there are smart features available in a refrigerator system which will be used to control the temperature automatically on and off the refrigerator, and to maintain the good quality of refrigeration. Okay, so this whole smart work or the intelligent work of this mechanical device will be controlled by a electronic circuit, and that circuit is containing the microcontroller, and that microcontroller is programmed specifically to control this AC. Okay, now we are going to discuss the third applications in the area of mobile and communication technologies. Okay, so you can see that inside the mobile there is a high end processor or controller chip is available. You can see it over here. Okay, so variety of chips or microcontrollers are embedded in a one smartphone. Okay, so all these things, like driving the screen, driving the call or connect with the network, capture the image through camera, processing it, managing the memory, everything will be controlled by the microcontroller chip. Okay, so the smartphone is a very important device, and which contains a very very high end microprocessor or microcontroller chips. Okay, so it is, microcontroller is used in the mobile phone as well as the infrastructure. You can see that mobile towers and network providing companies having their own infrastructure. Okay, so they are providing the connectivity, data services and everything. So they will have their own processing units and electronic hardware circuits. Okay, they will create or generate a network. Okay, so huge amount of hardware will be used in the infrastructure of the mobile network. This all are the programming based microcontrollers and high end chips are going to be used to establish 4G, 5G, 3G networks in our society, or to develop this particular infrastructure. Okay, so there are vast amount of microcontrollers used nowadays in this mobile and communication technologies. Okay, apart from mobile communication, there are several other types of communications are also there in our society that we will see in the next slide. Okay, let us discuss about the fourth application, which is medical science. Okay, so in a medical field, there are variety of instruments which is used to diagnose the patient or to generate several types of reports. Okay, like MRI, CT scan, blood report, urine report, microscope, or ultrasound, sonography. So variety of instruments are there nowadays in ventilators, nowadays in medical science. So without this all instrument, a doctor cannot do a efficient work. Okay, so you have to consider that a huge amount of electronic circuits, processors, controllers will be used to develop such kind of instruments. Okay, so in a medical field, there is a vast scope of microcontroller based circuits. Okay, so everywhere we can see that microcontrollers are there, but as an engineer we have to identify that where it is there and what is its work. Okay, that is very important. Now let us discuss the fifth application, which is in the area of robotics. Okay, so in a robotics we can see variety of robots nowadays available in a market to do different tasks. Okay, so nowadays some of the work of human can be handled by the robotics, and it is the emerging field. Nowadays there are advanced robot with the artificial intelligence are available in a market. Okay, so this all structure will be fabricated with the mechanical parts, motors, and electronic circuits. Okay, and to drive this particular robot in a systematic way, we need a smarter algorithm or a program which is embedded into the chips. Okay, so here a huge variety of robots available nowadays in a market looking like such a human, and also a one hand type of robot which will be mostly used for different types of work, for manufacturing to the management of some different plants. Okay, so this is also a huge field in the robotics. You can develop variety of applications and you can develop your particular circuit or system using microcontrollers to drive the particular robots. Now let us discuss on the next application, that is space industry. Nowadays space industries are growing very fastly. Okay, our ISRO is launching number of satellites. Okay, nowadays, okay, we have a very smart platform or this satellite launch vehicles nowadays available with our ISRO, which is Mark 3. Okay, GSLV Mark 3. So this is a launch vehicle to drive the launch vehicle, control the launch vehicle, to get the various data during the launching. So there are several systems and very complex systems are available inside this launch vehicle. Okay, so you can visit the ISRO and you can see that variety of parts are available to develop one satellite launch vehicle. So it contains a number of complicated embedded system and microcontrollers and circuits and everything to efficiently and perfectly drive this launch vehicle. Okay, now you can see that after launching of the satellite, this is the satellite in a space. Okay, so this satellite contains a communication equipment through which we can communicate various information which is uploaded from the Earth station, which is located somewhere on the Earth, and this will gives the signal to the satellite, and satellite will process this signal and give it to the another region where they have to broadcast. One important example of this technology right now we all are going to use, that is DTH services, direct to home, or dish TV. Okay, so all television broadcast is nowadays is digital, and we are receiving this satellite signal through the set-top box. Okay, so this satellite contains a different type of circuits, processing circuit, receiving circuit, transmitting circuit. So this whole circuit is a complex hardware of electronics, and which contains some microcontrollers and other systems are systems also. Okay, so there are variety of use in the satellite. Also to keep in track in the space, the satellite is rotating towards the Earth, so to keep in a perfect track or perfect orbit, it requires it having some different control mechanisms. So this control mechanism is also being fabricated with the help of mechanical parts and electrical parts, as well as electronic parts, communicating parts. So this is a complex and hybrid system where the role of microcontroller is 100% there. Now let us discuss the next application of microcontroller in artificial intelligence. Okay, so nowadays in a artificial intelligence is the latest field where we can assume that our machines or our gadget should work like a human, okay, or like a human brain. Okay, they can think about like human thinking. Okay, so the artificial intelligence is the combination of hardware and software. Okay, where the important part is software. Okay, where we are writing different types of algorithm, and through that algorithm, which is such kind of algorithm that we can that algorithm itself will start learning. Okay, and they are starting to think about human mind. Okay, like human mind thinking on different situation, the algorithm itself will start learning that what they have to take the decision on different situations. Okay, so it is again a latest topic, and nowadays lots of research are going on the AI base. So to process the algorithm for AI, we require some hardware, and that hardware is nothing but the computer or the microcontroller based hardware. Now let us discuss the next application, which is defense system. Okay, in a defense system we can use variety of applications in a defense, like navigation or making a complex missile guiding system or missiles. So this all applications will require telemetry and navigation equipments. Okay, and that equipments are developed with the electronic circuits, and which contains a different type of microcontrollers and complex softwares. Okay, so missile, after firing of the missile, they have to find or continuously track the target, or they have to take instant decisions that in which direction they have to go. Okay, so for that they required a very very high speed and complex electronic circuits which will be used to drive this particular system. Okay, now let us discuss The next application, navigation. Okay, so the use of the navigation will be used in a different places from our business to the aircraft navigation or the navigation through the satellite or navigation of different vehicles of a company or their fleet management. Okay, so variety of radars are available which will be used to scan different types of targets, okay, to guide the aviation system or to give the particular service to the aircraft. There are various type of air traffic systems are there or air traffic controllers are there. They need various types of radars and the scanning system which will find the object. They can find the range. They can communicate with the different object. So this is again a complex system, and this system is made up with the electronic hardware, and that is obviously the important part is their microprocessors and microcontrollers which is used to develop the system. Okay, now let us discuss the last application, that is IoT, that means Internet of Things. It is again a recent trend or recent technology in which nowadays a variety of works are going on. You can see that through a mobile or through a internet, you can control a number of devices, even a plant or a company also. You can control, monitor, or give the command, or you can navigate your far end systems. Okay, so Internet of Things is the combination of internet, and it is connected with the different platforms through which it can be a smart. Okay, that means the control operation of various devices can be handled through the internet. Okay, so Internet of Things nowadays is popular for variety of applications like home automation, factory automation, and plant automation, or variety of places it will be using. Okay, so to connect the ordinary devices with the internet, we need several platforms like NodeMCU, Arduino, or several internet based microcontroller circuits. Okay, so that circuit contains some communicating circuits plus microcontroller. So we can embed a specific softwares through which they can connect to the internet, and they can receive the command, send the command, and parallelly they will drive the devices also, and also they can continuously monitor the status of various devices. So it will be very helpful in a security or in a plant automation or home automation or many of the things nowadays. You can even do the answering in a WhatsApp automated. Okay, answering of the email automated. Okay, so this all are the vast field. We can make a different particular video for every technology or for every applications. Okay, so this lecture was about the brief of the applications of the microcontrollers. So in this semester, we are just starting with the 8051 microcontroller. Each and every microcontroller having several limitations. Okay, we can do everything with the 8051 microcontroller, that is not true. So according to requirement of the application, we have to select the different microcontrollers and different platforms or different softwares. Okay, so after learning this particular microcontroller, you will be able to understand different microcontrollers also. I hope you will enjoy this particular lecture and you will understand. Thank you.